Welcome to the .NET MAUI TreeMap Control tutorial. The .NET MAUI TreeMap Control enables the visual representation of hierarchical data using rectangles that are sized and colored based on underlying values. It effectively showcases grouped and nested data structures. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to add the .NET MAUI TreeMap Control to a .NET MAUI application. I'll show how to populate treemap items, apply background color, customize labels, group items, change layout, enable legend, multiselection, and tooltip. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022. And click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code in a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the Syncfusion.NET MAUI TreeMap control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI TreeMap NuGet package. First, open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI TreeMap package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So I open the AppSAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI TreeMap namespace. Then I initialize the MAUI TreeMap control to display American countries' population data. To implement this with the MVVM pattern, first, create a folder called Model and add a class named Population Details. Make this class public and define the fields continent, country, and population with appropriate data types. Next, to assign values to these fields, I create a folder called ViewModel and add a class named PopulationViewModel. Make this class public and define the property called PopulationData of type collection of PopulationDetails class. Add a constructor for the class. Inside this constructor, add the data object with the fields continent, country, and population to the PopulationData property. Once it is done, let me navigate to the main page XAML file to bind data. Here, I will import the namespace of the view model and add binding context to the content page. Access the population view model class here using the local XML namespace. Lastly, assign the population data property to the data source property and map the data source field population to the primary value path property to calculate leaf item size based on the population value. Then, define the leaf item brush settings property to apply the background color for the leaf items. Within this property, add a treemap uniform brush settings instance and set its brush to the appropriate color. Once the application is loaded, you can visualize the population details of the American countries using the treemap control. In the previous output, you would have seen the tree map without any details of a leaf item. Now, to display the country name in the leaf item, define the leaf item settings property. Within this, add a tree map leaf item settings instance and set its label path property to country. Look at the tree map control. The country names are displayed in the leaf item. Now let me show you how to group the leaf item based on the continent. For that, I add the levels property. Within this, add tree map level instance and set it the group path property to continent. Now you can see the leaf item is grouped by the continent. Next, I will demonstrate how to customize the leaf item background color based on population ranges. First, remove the treemap uniform brush settings. The treemap control offers four built-in brush settings: uniform, range, desaturation, and palette. In this example, I use the range brush settings. For more information on brush settings, please refer to the link provided in the description below. Now, add an instance of treemap range brush settings, and within it, add the range brushes property. Within this collection, include tree map range brush instance. Set the legend label to 50 million to 1 billion to display the text for the legend item associated with the range. Then set from property to 50 million for the starting value of the range, to property to 1 billion for the ending value of the range, and brush to the appropriate color. Similarly, include tree map range brush instances for 10 million to 50 million and 0.1 million to 10 million, each with different brush values. Finally, set the range color value path to population. Note that the range color mapping only works when range color value path is enabled. Checking here, different colors are applied to the leaf items based on their value. To provide information about the data displayed in the tree map, add the legend settings property. Within that, add a tree map legend settings element and set the show legend property to true. Looking here, the legend displays corresponding data at the top of the tree map. To provide additional information about specific tree map items when selected, set the show tooltip property to true. When the application is loaded, I choose a specific item, and you can see the tooltip displaying the corresponding population value. Next, I will show you different types of layouts in a tree map. By default, there are four types of layouts: squareified, slice and dice auto, slice and dice horizontal, and slice and dice vertical. By default, it is set to squareified. To customize it, set the layout type to slice and dice horizontal. When the application is loaded, rotate the emulator horizontally. You can see the rectangles are sliced based on population value and arranged horizontally. Now I will demonstrate how to enable the selection of multiple items. The tree map provides three options: single, multiple, and none. By default, only a single item can be selected. To enable the selection of multiple items, set the selection mode property to multiple. After the application loads, you can select multiple items. To customize the stroke width and color of the selected item, set the selected item's stroke to blue. Then set the selected item stroke width property to 4. By default, it's set to 2. You will notice that the selected item's stroke color and width are now customized. In this video, you learn how to add a .NET MAUI tree map control to the .NET MAUI application. I demonstrated how to populate treemap items, apply backgrounds and labels to treemap items, group items, apply different colors based on specified value ranges, change layout type, enable features such as legend, tooltip, and multiselection, and customize the appearance of selected items. To learn more about treemap control features, check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.